Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. Today, we're going to transform the default GNOME Terminal in Debian into something that looks and feels amazing. If you are tired of the plain old terminal and you want to make it more visually appealing, stick around. First things first, we're going to spice up the look of our terminal by adding a theme. You might not know this, but GNOME Terminal supports custom themes, and there is a cool tool called Gogh, or Gogh in Dutch, after the famous painter. That makes this process super easy. Gogh is a collection of color schemes for various terminal emulators, including the GNOME Terminal. A link to Gogh's GitHub is in the description of this video. Open your terminal and type the following commands to install a couple of tools which we will need for Gogh. Sudo apt-get install tconf-cli uuid-runtime. Next, let's run the Go script to choose a theme. Bash-c and then what is on your screen now. It will be linked in the description. This will bring up a list of themes. You can scroll through the options and once you find one that you like, just type the corresponding number and hit enter. I will go with Dracula, number 109, because it's easy on the eye and looks great. And I'm also going to install IBM 3270, number 164, because IBM mainframes, 3270 terminals and ZOS are just nostalgic to me. And green on black just looks great in my opinion. Select as many themes as you like. By right-clicking the terminal, you can check out and apply your new themes. I really like how quick I can switch between themes and also between light and dark modes. You can even have multiple themes across multiple tabs. You can further customize the themes and select a default theme. Now that our terminal has a fresh coat of paint, let's make the prompt itself look a bit more stylish with Powerline-go and some nice fonts. Powerline-go provides a beautiful and fast prompt for your shell, written in the Go language. Again, a link to the GitHub page is in the description of this video. First, we'll install the Go language. Type sudo apt install golang-go. And once Go is available, install powerline-go with the command go install github.com/justjen/powerline-go@latest. That will install it in the current directory, and in this case that is my home directory, and that is what I want. Adjust if you need to. And lastly, we need the powerline fonts. Type sudo apt install fonts powerline. Now set your terminal theme. I will use Dracula to use a powerline font. Open your terminal's preferences, go to the text or the font settings and choose a powerline compatible font like Deja Vu Sans Mono or any other powerline font you installed. Different fonts for different themes are also possible. After the installation is complete, we will need to modify our bash configuration to enable powerline. Let's edit the .bashrc file located in your user's home directory. I am using VI, but just use your favorite editor. Add the lines on screen now to the end of this file, also located in the description of this video for your convenience. Save and exit the file. Finally, let's apply the changes. For that, we can source or reload the bash configuration. Type source.bashrc. It did something, but I think it can look better. Let's try to restart the terminal. There we are. Our prompt now has a sleek, informative look thanks to powerline-go. Let me change into a subdirectory so you can see the prompt changing. By default, it shows the username, the hostname, and the present working directory. Everything you see can be adjusted, as almost always the case in Linux. When you navigate to a directory that needs permissions, a padlock icon is displayed. And when you go into a Git repository, the icon will change to a Git icon, and it will show you the current Git branch. When you type a non-existing command, or the return code of a command is an error, Powerline-go will change its colors to red. If there are multiple user accounts on this system, different power lines are possible per user, as each user will have their own .bashrc file. Now the last step is just for a little bit of fun, but to create a welcome banner for your terminal, let's install figlet for ASCII art and lolcat for coloring. Type sudo apt install figlet lolcat. Go back to the end of your .bashrc file and add any message you would like to run through lolcat. You can see where this is going. And to top it off, let's make sure the terminal is aware of its own identity and run it through figlet as well. Close and source .bashrc. Now every time you start a new terminal window or tab, it just looks a little bit different. Have fun with this and replace the text with, for example, the fortune command. And there you have it. Your GNOME terminal on Debian is now fully pimped out. From themes and fonts to custom prompts and banners, you've transformed your terminal into something that's not just functional, but also fun to use. That's it. Hope it helped. And if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time. Bye.